Hey everybody, welcome to Bible Party Online. Your week, I really hope, is going great. We're in the middle of the week. We just finished Hump Day. Congratulations to you. And we have two more days during the work week and then the weekend. But I'm glad you are here with me for Bible Party Online. I want to do, it's been a couple weeks since we've done this, I'd like to do a little Name That Tune. And because we had the Oscars this past Sunday, and the Oscars celebrates the best movies of the year, I thought we would do a movie-themed Name That Tune. So these songs are all famous because of the movies they were in. So let's see if we can name these tunes. Here is the first one. It might seem crazy what I'm about to say. Sunshine, she's here, you can take a break. I'm a hot air balloon that could go to space. With the air, like I don't care, baby, by the way. Okay, for these, if you know the name of the song, or if you know the name of the movie that the song was in, that counts too. So that song, for example, is called Happy, and it was in the Minions movie, I believe. Happy, which is a famous song, but I think it helped it become famous by being in the Minions movie, which I will admit I have not seen. I need to go watch the Minions movie. Our second one here is also a song that got famous from a movie. That song is called Gonna Fly Now, but you might know the movie. It's more likely that you know the movie Rocky. Rocky, that is the theme from Rocky when he's running and he runs up the stairs and he's training, and that's the music there. We have one more song. Let's see how we do. Everything is awesome. Everything is cool when you're part of a team. Everything is awesome when we're living our dream. Everything is better when we stick together. Side by side, you and I gonna win forever. Let's party forever. All right, that is called Everything is Awesome. And that is from the Lego movie, which was so good. So that is our Name That Tune, finishing with the Lego movie, Everything is Awesome. And whether you watch the Oscars or not, I did not watch them, but I love movies and it was fun to do that. Let's open in prayer and then we will see what the Bible has to say today. But let's pray together. God, you are good, and we praise you and worship you, and we thank you for this evening and the opportunity to learn more about you. We pray, God, that you would bless this time, that you would speak to us, and that you would move in our hearts. In your name we pray. Amen. Well, y'all, as a reminder, some of you heard this on Sunday, but some of you may not have. Two quick things that I have seen among many. I've seen a lot of things that seemed like an accident that God probably did. But two of the things that I've seen, I'll share. First, I'll even give you a different one. First, my family was moving to a part of town that was new and was different, and my mom wasn't comfortable at first moving to this new part of town. But she had grown up on a farm, and she told my dad, you know, if we could live in a farmhouse, I would feel a lot better about moving to this new part of town. Now, this was in the middle of the city, so we're not going to find a farmhouse. There's no way. But we were looking for houses, and my parents found a house that originally had been a farmhouse. What are the odds of that? In the middle of the city. They took it as a sign from God that that was where they were supposed to be. They ended up living there, and it was great. That was just an accident that really, you know, that's God at work, isn't it? Another example, just in my family's history, my parents had given more than usual to our church, given more money than usual to our church during one season because they thought that's what God wanted them to do. And something came up, and I don't remember what it was, but they were all of a sudden in need of money. They were short on money. And it was because they had given more than they were used to the church. And so they prayed about it and asked God to provide. And, you know, accidentally, later that week, they got a check that they were not expecting. I think it was from the IRS or something, for the exact amount that they needed. You know, was that just an accident, or was that God at work? I would say that's God at work. And I would say that God can use accidents, in quotation marks, for good. God can use accidents, things that seem like accidents, for good. Now, where we left off in our Esther's story last week was Haman, the bad guy. Haman is going to kill Esther's cousin, Mordecai. Esther loves Mordecai. This would be a huge blow. And there's nothing she can do about it, though. Remember, Esther is queen of Persia. But she doesn't realize that this is happening. And Xerxes doesn't realize that Mordecai is related to her. The king doesn't realize that Mordecai is the cousin of his queen, so he's going to give permission to Haman to kill Mordecai, and there's nothing Esther can do about it. However, when we pick up in Esther chapter 6, the king, Xerxes, can't sleep one night. I had trouble sleeping last night myself, but the king here, he can't sleep. He's tossing and turning. He just can't sleep. So he gets up, you know, just he accidentally can't sleep. He calls in a servant, has him bring a book, and that servant accidentally brings in this book that in it tells the story of years earlier when Mordecai saved the king's life. Now, the king had forgotten about this. And he realizes, this Mordecai guy, did he get a reward for saving my life? And the servant says, no. And so the king is like, oh, I got to reward this Mordecai man. So as the king is thinking about that, just accidentally again, right? And when I say accidentally, you know, God is at work in all these accidents, all these things that seem to happen by accident, God is really doing them, right? Just as the king is thinking about this, Haman, the bad guy Haman, comes in. And he is going to ask the king for permission to kill Mordecai. But the king, before Haman can ask that, the king asks Haman, Haman, what should I do for a man who I respect and value? What should I do, Haman, for a man that I respect and value. Now you remember, Haman is really self-centered and selfish. He only thinks about himself. And so he thinks, the king values and respects me. So he's probably looking for ideas to reward me. So I should give him a really great idea, and then he will reward me. All right, and he thinks, and then he gives this answer to the king. Oh, king, what you should do is you should have this man that you respect and value, you should give him one of your royal robes and let him wear it for the day. And you should set him on one of your grand royal horses. And you should throw a parade for him and let him go throughout the city. And you should have somebody going in front of him shouting to everybody that this man the king respects and values. And Haman's all excited because he's like, I'm finally going to get back at my enemy Mordecai, and I'm going to get this reward of having a parade thrown for me, and I'm going to have the king's robe and the king's horse, and everyone's going to respect me, and it's going to be great. But then the king says something that he did not expect. He says, go and do this for Mordecai. Oh no. Haman's enemy. He can't stand Mordecai. And here he thought he was going to be able to get rid of his enemy. And instead, he gave the king the idea to reward him in this amazing way. And worse yet, he has to go in front of Mordecai during the parade and shout to everybody that the king respects and values Mordecai. So Haman goes home and he cries to mommy at the end of the day. But God saves Mordecai's life. You see, it wasn't Esther. She didn't even know about this. It wasn't any person, but it was God using the accidents of the king waking up, of the king reading a certain book and reading a certain page and having Haman come in at that moment. God can use accidents for good. Accidents happen all the time to us, don't they? Things just happen. We don't think much of them. But God can use accidents for good. Is it an accident that you are listening to me right now? That you are watching this Bible party online? Is it just an accident? Or did God want you to be here right now learning about him? I would say God designed that to happen. God can use accidents for good. And the last thing I'll say on this is that God used the accident of a baby born in Bethlehem 2,000 years ago who was his son in human form to save us through his death and resurrection. God is that amazing. All right, let's write a card to somebody to share what we learned today. Why am I talking like this? I don't know. But I thought we would write a card this week. Again, in keeping with our movie themed week, we'd write a card to an actor named Harrison Ford. And Harrison Ford is Han Solo in Star Wars. He is Indiana Jones. He is in a lot of movies, a lot of good ones. But let's write to him and share what we talked about today. So let's say this. Dear Mr. Ford, you are a great actor. Thank you for all your work. At the Brookwood Community this week, we talked about how God can use accidents for good. Remember, Jesus died on the cross for our sins and he rose from the grave, and we can put our faith in him. your friends, the famous citizens of the Brookwood community. Boom. There you go. Well, let's get up and let's have a little bit of fun dancing to some music. Let's close in prayer, y'all. Would you pray with me? God, we love you and we praise you and we worship you and we thank you for this time together. We thank you that you can use accidents for good, and we pray you would give us eyes to see how you are constantly at work all around us, even in accidents, things that seem like accidents. We know that you are alive and at work in our lives, and we praise you for it. It's in your name we pray. Amen. Y'all, take care, and it is almost May, so enjoy the rest of April, and I will see you, most of you probably, in May.